Very good evening, friends. Not compliance. It's a time-bound compliance that is very important nowadays. And on the time machine, March has a very, very, very important role to play. यानी पुराने समय में ऐसे भी केसेस मिले कि 2 लाख का टैक्स पेमेंट नहीं किया और 2 करोड़ की टैक्स लाइबिलिटी आदमी के ऊपर आ गई. इतने बड़े बड़े मैटर हुए थे. उस समय ये प्रोग्राम डिजाइन किया था मेकिंग मार्च मीनिंगफुल. यानी 31 मार्च के पहले नॉर्मली आदमी ने क्या क्या प्रिकॉशन ले लेनी चाहिए वो एक कॉन्सेप्ट था. क्या अगर टाइम निकल गया तब तो आदमी के हाथ में कुछ भी नहीं करने को होता है बेसिकली. तो ठीक है, 31 मार्च के पहले क्या क्या प्रिकॉशन ले लेना, ये मेकिंग मार्च मीनिंगफुल प्रोग्राम डिजाइन किया था. एंड आई एम वेरी हैप्पी टू इन्फॉर्म यू ऑल, this is his 10th year of making March meaningful. And we are constantly having this program regularly. We have with us a very, very decent personality, a perfect gentleman, transfer pricing expert, and a representative for Big Four in a very lot many MNCs. He is a chartered accountant and an advocate. Advocate Kapil Hirani with us. I would request the chairman of BIA Tax Forum, Ashok Chandakar, to please welcome him by offering a floral bouquet. Friends, on indirect tax front, we have a past president of Celtic Bar Association who is always ready for the programs of BIA Tax Forum, a very meticulous in his approach and a very disciplined working with a clear concept. CA Mahendra Jain sir, I would request CA PC Sardarji to please welcome him by offering a floral bouquet. Normally, in making March meaningful, we are having direct tax and indirect tax only. But this time, another center has been added. It's a corporate law. Lot many compliances are required in corporate law, and there are a lot of penalty for non-compliance. So, in normal course, what should be done before 31st March, we are covering in corporate law also. We have the past president of both the Institute of Company Secretaries as well as Institute of Chartered Accountants of India, a vice president of VIA Tax Association, Sri O.S. Bagadia ji. I would request Jamanjar ji to please welcome him by offering a floral bouquet. We have with us an authority in indirect tax, who is the chairman of Tax and Corporate Law Forum, an authority on all the fields, whatever he is in. He is a past president of the Institute of Chartered Accountants of India and the chairman of BIA Tax Forum, Ashok Chandakar. I would request him for his welcome ahead.
Speaker for today's program, my friend, Mr. Kapil Hirani, Mr. Udhay Pagaiya, Mr. Mahendra Jain, Naresh Jakhotia, Sachin, dear friends, on behalf of BIA Taxation and Corporate Law Forum, I welcome you all to this program, which is titled as Making March Meaningful. Naresh Jakhotia has already pointed out to you the objective of this program. We have an uniform accounting that is 31st March. And every year, whenever 31st March comes, we need to close our books of accounts. Before closing the books of accounts, something or other is required to be done under all laws. Be it a direct tax or indirect tax or a corporate law. Since this is a BIA Taxation and Corporate Laws Forum, we thought it fit to include the corporate law also in this today's program. I'm sure after the end of this program, all of you will realize which are the small matters which everyone is required to comply with. And if you don't comply with those matters, what are going to be the consequences? Consequences are very harsh, resulting from penalty, disallowances of your eligible expenses, heavy demands under both laws, direct tax laws, indirect tax laws. The accountants and the chartered accountants plays very important role. Normally we observe that nobody approaches his counsel. When I say the counsel, it may be advocate, it may be a chartered accountant, it may be a tax practitioner, it may be company secretary or cost accountant. Before things are being done, and then the consultant is approached, what we should do. It is always said that half knowledge is always dangerous, and things which have been done before approaching the consultant are always with half knowledge. We don't claim that by attending this seminar or a program, you will become an expert in the field. But at least you will have a basic knowledge as to what is to be done and what is not to be done. And if you encounter some issue in relation to those issues which are going to be discussed in today's program, it will force you to approach your consultant and to take a proper advice and thereafter plan. In my professional career, I have seen mostly an assessee suffers because of the small mistakes made by the accountants. I don't blame you, because you are basically trained in completing the financial accounts, tallying the trial balance and doing the balance sheet and all those things. But small mistakes can be avoided. In spite of that, there could be a big mistake. There could be a mistake which may have a big penalty. But at least routine matters can be avoided, and that is what is purpose of this program. I therefore welcome you all to this program. And today, as has been pointed out to you, we have a panel of experts to deal with issues which we are required to look into before 31st March, and maybe there are certain issues which are required to be looked into even immediately after 31st March as well. Possibly those things will also be discussed by the speakers today. Thank you very much for your attendance in large number for this meeting.
फ्रेंड्स जी कॉन्सेप्ट इज दैट कि हम लोग चाहते हैं कि दो घंटे डेढ़ घंटे के अंदर में पूरे टॉपिक कवर हो जाए और एकदम शॉर्ट में क्रिस्प में पूरे बेनिफिट मिले लोगों को एक्चुअली, तो वो हिसाब से डेढ़ दो घंटे के ट्रेनर में पूरा प्रोग्राम कवर करना चाहते हैं और वो कॉन्सेप्ट से रखें कि अपने बिजी जो हेक्टिक बिजनेस लाइफ होती है उसमें टाइम निकाल के एक आधे घंटे में एक घंटे में एक एक टॉपिक कवर हो जाए ताकि यू गेन द बेनिफिट ऑफ दैट टाइम इज शॉर्ट. to cover such a vast topic. But especially I am thankful to the galaxy of my speaker for just trying to manage the part and covering the entire episode in such a limited time. We will begin. I would request Advocate Kapil Hirani to cover his presentation on that. Thank you.
Very good evening, all of you.
Good evening.
Respected Chandak sir, my fellow speakers, Maria sir, Mr. Jain, Naresh, who is a dear friend, Sachin, and all of you present here, thank you so much for giving me this opportunity. It is always a pleasure to come before the DIA forum and to discuss a topic which normally is of extreme importance so far as I am concerned, and I feel that it is very appropriate and apt that such a program is organized. I would try my level best to discuss certain issues which I personally feel are important but often overlooked. As Chandak sir rightly pointed out, simple issues but having far-reaching implications and problems so far as the SSEs are concerned. I would be very happy to answer any questions, any doubts that you might have, which we can during the course of my talk, or we can have it after that also. To start with, let me start with the basic compliances that SSEs are expected to comply with so far as MARS is concerned. Gradually, I would be throwing some light on certain other issues which I feel you can keep an eye on as proprietors, as accountants, that will help you or at least give you a far better footing in case in future your direct tax assessments are taken up. To start with, as you're all are aware, that 15th March is the due date for the payment of the fourth advance tax installment. The government expects that we should estimate whatever tax liability we are going to have for the year as reduced by whatever TDS, TCS that has already been deducted, collected, and pay the balance in installments, and the final installment being 15th March. What I would suggest, previously, I used to always say that pay your advance taxes very, very carefully to avoid any penal interest that might be levied on you. I have no hesitation in saying that this approach of mine has changed in the past couple of years. I now actually have been telling people, pay your advance tax slightly lower than what you estimated to be. I have been advising clients to let there be a certain amount of demand which is there, which you can pay at the time of filing of your return as a self-assessment tax. The reason, in the past couple of years, what we have been seeing is an extreme amount of notices that we are being received on account of very, very old dues which have been uploaded on the income tax site by the income tax department. If I am correct, about two or three years back, the department was given instructions and a deadline to upload all the existing demands that they might be having. So, irrespective of whether there is a rectification application pending, whether proper credits have not been given, whether there are any grievances which the assessee has already pointed out to the department, which has not yet been given effect to, which would have the result of nullifying the demand, just with the intention of complying with the deadline, the income tax department uploaded each and every pending demand that they had for the past many years. If you see the notices which have been coming presently, you would see outstanding demand of even as old as maybe 2007. The problem with such old demands is we have absolutely no documents at this point of time to
verify as to why this demand has actually been subsisting at this point of time. And in absence of any reply, what the department is doing, they are giving you a notice that please reply to this within a specific period of time. If no reply has been received, the subsequent refund is going to be adjusted. So simply what is happening, because it pertains to such old periods and the data is not readily available with the client, and I'm very sure these demands are in a sense not due. There might be cases where it is, I'm not denying that, but in majority of the cases what we are seeing is the demand has arisen on account of certain lacunas, errors, human, machine errors on the part of the department, because of which the credit has not been received. The result being, if there is a refund, normally that refund is not seeing the light of the day because of such unjust adjustments which are being done by the department. Keeping this in mind, I have been advising people to just be slightly conservative with your advance tax payments. Leave a gap of 10%. So that can be paid, that differential interest might be far more beneficial for you than fighting for the refund that is rightly due. So you can keep that thing in mind. That is something that I have been advising to my clients regularly. Considering that we are on the subject of refunds, please analyze your returns for the past 2-3 years and ascertain the reason for which such excessive refunds are being arisen. One could be excessive TDS deductions that are being done, excessive TCS collections that are being done. If that is the case, I would strongly suggest